get to this address, huh?
We get to the house. It didn't look like it was busting at the seams with people. And there was maybe one or two cars in the driveway. And I'm still on the street. And I have the passenger side facing the driveway. And he said, John, can you just run in there and, like, you know, can we make sure we're welcome here and it's somewhere we want to be? He said, yeah, I'll be right back. And he got out of the car.
Goes to the front door of the house?
Yes.
Did you see him go in the house?
Yeah, I saw him approach the front door and put his hand on the door.
In your memory, he's going towards a friend's house. How far do you see him go?
I see him go to the door and start to cross the threshold. And I'm thinking, all right, let me look at my phone. And I know sooner
you don't see the door open, you don't see him greet the door.
It's going
on,
man.
I see him open the door and put his head inside. And I'm like, all right, he's going to come out and get me.
It's cool.
And I look down at my phone, and in a matter of seconds, I look up, and he's not there. And then I waited for him to reemerge, which I assumed was going to be in moments, or that he'd yell to me from the front door, okay.
It's good. Come on in.
Yeah, come on in.
Wow. But that never happened.
I'm going to let everybody know.
He didn't come back.
When I met with Karen, this is exactly the same story that she told me, word for word.
One, I didn't really want to be there. Two, I had to go to the bathroom.
But where is he?
Yeah. It's 12:30. And I'm waiting here in the snow, in the darkness. I don't know these people well. And what did you say to have a beer? Why aren't you signaling to me? So soon thereafter, within, Dennis, probably 2 full minutes, I start calling him.
Are you getting ticked at him?
Yeah, I am ticked at him at this time, yeah.
So what happens next?
I left.
You're in your car. Will you say, I'm out of here?
No, I kind of slow rolled it off the street. And I'm hoping that as I slowly edge my way down the street, he's going to say, wait, Karen, where are you going?
Okay, so there you are. You're headed home.
Yeah, I went home. I was home within probably 7 minutes.
Home was John's place.
And what do you do?
I laid on the couch inside the front door. And I just called him. I called him just over 50 times.
50 times?
Yep. Yep. And they were just going to voicemail.
It's getting very early in the morning at this point.
Yeah, I fell asleep. When I woke up after 4, I knew something was wrong.
Where in the world was John O'Keefe?
I didn't know what the hell happened. How did the night end up like this?
Dirty.
Yeah. Smudge.
When my hair started to thin,
she tells the story very well there.
Let me just turn the go ahead.
She tells the story very well there. She's honest, she's transparent. You can tell she's not kind of trying to recall things and doubt things. It's the same story every single time. It's no hesitation. She knows her story because it's not a story, it's just the truth.
It's definitely, honestly, I can tell everybody, I'll be very transparent about this. When I met with Karen and had dinner with her, what, about a month ago? Maybe a little, actually, it was a little bit longer than that. Literally word for word, it's the same story that she told me. Mm-hmm. It's the same story that she told me. I'm going to tell you, I don't think people realize when you meet with her and you sit down and you actually talk to her about her case, she is like, how can I say that? A supercomputer when it comes to her case. She knows every single intimate detail of how things were, what it was like, what the cold felt like that night, what was the temperature. Mm-hmm. She knows everything. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's nothing that you're going to get by on Karen Reed. Karen, what do you think so far, Lauren?
I mean, I'm enjoying it so far, but I agree with everything you said. You don't have to remember anything if you're telling the same story every time, you know?
It is literally the same story that she told me. Literally the same story.
Yeah.
Let's see. Cindy B says, my heart just absolutely breaks for her. Let's see. What guilty person, Deb says, Deb for justice, what guilty person would call out over 50 times? Mm-hmm. Let's see.
It would make no sense to call out many times.
And then Papa says, what if Karen went inside with him? I still wonder. I wonder about that. That's a good scenario too.
Yep.
You know, what would have happened?
Yeah.
My heart breaks for her. Tammy says, Teresa's here. Let's see. She retains a good memory. Plus, it's the truth. So it's heartbreaking.
Right.
Absolutely.
Right.
Yep. And that's what I was saying. And I was just getting around to is that it's literally the same story. Because when you know what happened. You don't have to manufacture lies. You just put this out.
And like if you were on the witness stand, for example, and you had to keep referring to certain pages every 10 seconds when you're on the stand, you're probably someone that maybe not is knowing the truth.
Yeah. And your story changes every 5 seconds.
You know who I'm talking about. Yeah, and I'm saying that to our audience. I think they do. I think they know who I'm talking about. Shock and horror.
Yeah.
Yeah. Shock and horror.